Good afternoon to all. Today we are discussing that second topic from that seventh lesson, atoms, molecules and chemical reactions. From this chapter we will discussing some points. Myself B. Rajendra, school assistant physical science, JPHS Nuttankal. Yesterday what I am explained and what we discuss, that once again you have to recall. So we are just watching that yesterday's lesson. We hear the words as matter, substance, compounds, elements and atoms. Substance, matter, these examples are water, food, oil and air. For compounds, water, oxygen, carbon dioxide, coal, starch. For atoms, we are listening some examples as oxygen, hydrogen, carbon, etc. As well as elements also, we listen the words similarly, oxygen, hydrogen, carbon, iron. The Latin name is ferrum, sodium, magnesium, silver, like that. So the scientist who is father of modern chemistry, Antoni Leveis, discovered the law of conservation of mass. Law of conservation of mass. If you burn or combustion the coal, at last we will get there some ash, heat and some carbon dioxide gas. Compared to these two, before of the chemical reaction, means before of the combustion, how much of the mass is here? After combustion, means after completion of the chemical reaction, what much of the ash will be remain? Compared to these two, where does the matter of charcoal go? That answer already we explained, that mass doesn't destroy or doesn't goes up. It will be change its form as carbon dioxide, water vapor and heat. As well as in that situation of rusting a iron nail. Before of the rusting, it is having some mass. After rusting, it is having more mass, means increasing the mass because of reaction with the oxygen from the atmosphere, that mass of the oxygen added to this iron nail. So after rusting, the weight of the iron rod is increasing. As well as from 8th class metals and non-metals lesson, we burnt magnesium ribbon and sulfur. Before of the combustion or burning, how much weight is there? And after combustion or burning, how much of the ash remain product having mass? Both we compare, there is a little bit difference are there. So are the weights of the reactants and products same or differ? For these questions, we done a lab activity. That lab activity given in our textbook. This aim of the lab activity is that to find out the change in the mass before and after a chemical reaction. To find out the change in the mass before and after a chemical reaction. For this, materials we need are required: lead nitrate, PbNO3 taken twice, potassium iodide, Ki, distilled water, conical plus 2, 250 ml size, and spring valence, small test tube, a retard stand, and a rubber cork. First of all, we are preparing a solution of lead nitrate. We take 2 grams of lead nitrate in a spatula and dissolves in 100 ml of distilled water. So we get that colorless of 2 grams of lead nitrate solution. And prepare another solution of potassium iodide. Here also we take 2 grams of potassium iodide and dissolves in 100 ml of distilled water. It is also a colorless solution. From this potassium iodide solution, we took 4 ml of solution only. Take 4 ml of solution of potassium iodide in a small test tube. After that, we took 100 ml of lead nitrate in a 250 ml of conical glass. In this solution, we hang 4 ml of potassium iodide small test tube with the help of thread and tighten the conical glass with a rubber cork. This total apparatus hang to the spring balance and note that weighs. The weight is before after the chemical reaction. One recording is what is that? The total weight of the apparatus before of the chemical reaction. Now we tilt and swirl the flasks. Then the test tube is moving and that 4 ml of potassium iodide will mix with 100 ml of lead nitrate. The combination of or mixing of potassium iodide and lead nitrate gave a chemical reaction and a change. We observe that what chemical change will be, what color will be changed, that you note down. Observe the change of color. After completion of this reaction, once again have to weigh the total apparatus with the help of spring balance. Then this weight also you note down. What will be happens if lead nitrate solution is added to that potassium iodide solution? Here we are observing that a yellowish color lead iodide is formed and potassium nitrate also formed. That yellow precipitate is formed due to the completion of the chemical reaction in between of lead nitrate and potassium iodide. So from our textbook, this is the figure 1. Before of the chemical reaction, we take our 250 ml flask and make 400 ml of lead nitrate and hang 4 ml of potassium iodide in the test tube with the help of thread and tighten with the rubber cork and hang to the spring balance and record the weights of this total apparatus. After tilting and swirling of the conical flask, the small test tube the potassium iodide and lead nitrate will be mixed and occurs the chemical reaction and forms that yellowish precipitate. So that's why the completion of the chemical reaction, we will be once again weigh the total apparatus with the help of spring balance and record the total weight of the apparatus after completion of a chemical reaction, before of mixing and after mixing. These two records we will be note down in our results sheet. So before of the chemical reaction, before of the mixing, we got that 127 grams only. And after that also, we will be get that 127 grams. Means the mass is doesn't change before of the chemical reaction and after the chemical reaction. And we observe that yellowish color precipitate is also formed. The result is that a chemical reaction takes place and the mass remains same before and after the chemical reaction. Therefore, mass is neither created nor destroyed in a chemical reaction. Therefore, mass is neither created nor destroyed in a chemical reaction. Up to here, we are discussing in our last class. Now we continue this one. Matter can neither be created nor destroyed. It can only change its form. Only change its form. In the example of charcoal, we get that ash, but it is not equivalent to the mass of charcoal. Before the chemical reaction, mass is not equivalent to after the chemical reaction. But the matter is not destroyed. It will be changed in the form of water vapor, carbon dioxide gas, and some mass converted to the heat. So this total, these four products, if you add it, that mass is equivalent to the mass of the charcoal. So that's why before of the chemical reaction, how much of the mass is there, that much of the mass is after the chemical reaction. So matter never we can be created, we can be destroyed. Means matter can neither be created nor destroyed. It can only change its form. Did you observe any precipitate in that reaction? Yes. That is yellowish precipitate. Did you think that a chemical reaction has taken place in the flask? Yes. Yellowish precipitate forms means lead nitrate and potassium iodide participate in the chemical reaction and also occurs the chemical reaction. After completion of the chemical reaction, it is forms that yellowish precipitate for lead iodide. So these two questions are given in our textbook. For this, I write here, these two questions answers is, and a chemical reaction is that PbNO3, lead nitrate plus Ki, potassium iodide, gives rise to KNO3 plus PbI2. Potassium nitrate plus lead iodide. So first question answer is yellowish precipitate is formed. And the second question answer is that yes, a chemical reaction is occurred. From this lab activity, we concluded that no change in weights before and after a chemical reaction. So every lab activity having a result, after recording, we can conclude it and gives that result. That result is that a chemical reaction takes place and the mass remains same before and after the chemical reaction. Therefore, mass is neither created nor destroyed in a chemical reaction. This result, after this experiment, Antoni Lavoisier gives a statement that is nothing but conservation of mass, law of conservation of mass, that expressed in that statement. In any chemical reaction, the initial weights of reactants is equivalent to the final weights of products. Or mass is neither created nor destroyed during a chemical reaction, but it only changes from one form to another. Do you get the same result if the conical flask is not closed? In the experiment, we tighten the conical flask with a rubber cork. If we did not tighten or we did not close the conical flask, the same result means before of the chemical reaction and after the chemical reaction, the mass will be same. Do you get or not? That means sometimes we not get the same result. Maybe the difference will be coming in the masses before of the chemical reaction and after the chemical reaction. Why? Because some gases will be evolved in that chemical reaction. If that gases are evolved, then it will be goes from that open area. So sum of the mass we will be lost to calculate. So that's why the answer is no. Some gases will be evolved. If any gas or any matter doesn't goes out, we conditionally put that all will be hold in that experiment with conditions, then the mass doesn't change during a chemical reaction. Any gas, anything, if you evolves, that are all if you catch, if you hold, then the before of the mass is equivalent to the after the chemical reaction. So mass doesn't change during a chemical reaction without any loss. Antoni Levasseur, on the basis of his experiment, he proposed the law of conservation of mass. As matter is neither created nor destroyed during a chemical reaction, more simply, the mass of product is equivalent to the mass of the reactants in a chemical reaction. This is gives the statement. After the Antoni Levasseur experiment and statement, it is verified by the Lon Dalton. The scientist name is Lon Dalton. Who is Lon Dalton? What is his experiment? What is it? Hans Heinrich Lon Dalton. He is the one of the scientists who verified the law of conservation of mass, who explained by the Antoni Levasseur. That statement is verified by the another scientist, Lon Dalton. Lon Dalton was a German chemist. He proved law of conservation of mass experimentally by using H glass tube filled with silver nitrate in a tube and also hydrochloric acid in another tube. He is taken two chemicals, one is silver nitrate and another one is hydrochloric acid. Before of the chemical reaction, the masses of silver nitrate and HCl in order, and after the chemical reaction and also in order, at last he concluded and verified that the total mass of reactants before reaction is equivalent to the total mass of reaction after a reaction. He take another two examples also like that. Water forms by union of hydrogen and oxygen. Hydrogen combine with oxygen gives that water. So the weight of the hydrogen and weight of the oxygen before the chemical reaction in order, and after the combustion of hydrogen and oxygen releasing the water vapor, that water vapor also hold and find that weight, that means product, that is also equivalent to the before of the chemical reaction. So the mass of the reactants means H2 plus O2, hydrogen plus oxygen, is equivalent to water molecule weight, means product weight. So the weight of iron increasing on rusting. We are observing that pictures, iron nails rusting. For that question answer, he also experimentally verified the weight of iron increases on rusting. Why? Because the iron is react with oxygen from the atmosphere. So the adding of the mass of oxygen after chemical reaction, so that's why the weight will be increasing. So the weight of iron increases on rusting. The increasing in weight is equivalent to the weight of oxygen added to that iron. And after that, another law of constant proportion is explained by Joseph Louis Frost with experiments. Law of constant proportions. Okasari ikkada manam telugulo chuddam. Law of constant proportions ante ఒక పదార్థము ఏర్పడేటప్పుడు అందులో పాల్గొనేటువంటి ఆటమ్స్ యొక్క రేషియో ఎప్పుడు కూడా కాన్స్టాంట్ గా స్థిరంగా ఉంటుంది అనేటువంటి అర్థంతో ఈ నియమం ఉన్నది దీని జోసెఫ్ లూయిస్ ఫ్రాస్ట్ వివరించడం జరిగింది సో లా ఆఫ్ కాన్స్టాంట్ ప్రపోర్షన్స్ ద రేషియో ఆఫ్ ఆటమ్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ ఇన్వాల్వ్స్ ఇన్ దట్ ఫార్మేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఏ మాలిక్యూల్ దట్ రేషియోస్ ఆల్వేస్ constant if you prepare the molecule in any way nu edaina oka anuvunu e rakanga tayar chesina andulo undetuvanti moolakala yokka nishpatti matrame eppudu kuda sthiranga untundi deenni joseph louis frost vivarinchadam jarigindi deen kosam atadu em chesadu anedi manam chudam he took two samples of copper carbon and oxygen he took a copper element carbon element and oxygen element and formation of the copper oxide carbon oxide means carbon monoxide carbon dioxide in this way he prepared the products by the chemical reactions in between of copper carbon and oxygen after that he weighs before of the chemical reaction and after the chemical reaction with that he find that ratio the ratio is always constant so a statement given like that law of constant proportion Frost took two samples of carbon copper carbonate a compound of copper carbon and oxygen copper carbonate the product is that copper carbonate before of the chemical reaction he take that copper carbon and oxygen the mass of these three elements copper plus carbon plus oxygen how much after the chemical reaction he will be get that same mass of the copper carbonate first law is fulfilled and after that he prepared and decomposed he prepared this one in different methods at last he find that the percentage of copper carbon and oxygen in the two samples are same means the ratio of this reactants are constant in that product For this, he gave in a table. If you take the natural sample and a synthetic sample, both are having the same ratios. From this table one, we observe like this one. Based on his experiments, Frost put forward the law of constant proportions. It states that a given chemical substance always contains the same elements combined in a fixed proportions by mass this means that relative proportion of elements in a compound is independent of the source or method of preparation ikkada deen ardham endante manamu oka padarthanni ye vidhanga tayar chesina ye paddhatilo tayar chesina andulo palgone moolakala yokka సంయోగ స్థితి అనేది ఒకే స్థిరమైన నిష్పత్తిలో ఉంటుంది ఉదాహరణకు నీటిని మనం హైడ్రోజన్ ఆక్సిజన్ మండించడం ద్వారా తయారు చేయవచ్చు ఒక యాసిడ్ ను ఒక బేస్ ని కలపడం ద్వారా తయారు చేయవచ్చు ఇంకా రకరకాల కెమికల్ రియాక్షన్స్ ద్వారా కూడా వాటర్ వేపర్ తయారవుతుంది వాటర్ తయారవుతుంది మనం ఏ విధంగా వాటర్ ని తయారు చేసినప్పటికీ In any way, in any method, if you prepare a water molecule, that water molecule contains two hydrogen and one oxygen, H2O, H2O. The ratio of the hydrogen and oxygen 2:1 in the water molecule. If you prepare a carbon dioxide gas, in any way you prepare the carbon dioxide gas, carbon. Computed with oxygen or calcium carbonate means limestone, sunaprayani, if you heat it up, it releases the carbon dioxide. This is another method. In any way, if you prepare the carbon dioxide, that carbon dioxide substance always contains one carbon element and two oxygen elements. The ratio of the carbon and oxygen 1:2 in the carbon dioxide gas, carbon dioxide molecule. So in this, like a given chemical substance always contains the same elements combined in a fixed proportion by mass. This statement is given by the Joseph Louis Prost in the form of law of constant or law of constant proportions. Similarly, Faust took water from different sources and found that the weight of percentage of oxygen and hydrogen was the same in all samples. There was no relation between the place from where the sample came and its composition. If you take that ice from Canada, from polar region, if you take salty water from any ocean, if you take a water sample from a well, in this way, you have to collect the sample of water molecule. All are having the ratios as hydrogens as 2 and oxygen as 1. So the ratio of the hydrogen and oxygen is fixed in the constant of the 2:1 proportions. So in any way we prepare water, the ratio is 2:1 only. This is the law of constant proportions. There are two questions from our textbooks. One question is 100 gram of mercury oxide decomposes to give 92.6 grams of mercury and 7.4 grams of oxygen. Let I explain in Telugu. Mercury oxide ane oka padartham teeskoni adi oka 100 gramla baru unnadani teeskoni manam danni vedi chesthe adi vidipothundi ela vidipothundi mercury ga oxygen ga vidipoyinappudu manam aa gases ni collect chesthe మెర్క్యూరీ కూడా వాటర్ వేపర్ గా మారుతుంది, ఆక్సిజన్ కూడా వేపర్ గా ఉంటుంది. కాబట్టి గ్యాసెస్ అంటాం. వాటిని కలెక్ట్ చేసినట్లయితే అప్రాక్సిమేట్లీ 92.6 grams ఆఫ్ మెర్క్యూరీ మనకు కలెక్ట్ అవుతుంది, 7.4 grams ఆఫ్ ఆక్సిజన్ కలెక్ట్ అవుతుంది. దీని ఇలా పక్కకు పెట్టేసుకున్నాం ఈ క్యాల్కులేషన్స్. ఇప్పుడు ఏం చేద్దామంటే, ఒకవేళ మన దగ్గర 10 grams ఆఫ్ ఆక్సిజన్ ఉన్నది, 125 grams ఆఫ్ మెర్క్యూరీ ఉంది. మెర్క్యూరీ మీన్స్ పాదరసం. ఈ రెండింటిని మనం కనుక కాంబినేషన్ చేద్దాం, అంటే ఈ రెండింటిని కలిపినప్పుడు కెమికల్ రియాక్షన్ జరిగి మెర్క్యూరీ ఆక్సైడ్ ఏర్పడుతుంది. ఫస్ట్ ఏమో మనం మెర్క్యూరీ ఆక్సైడ్ను డికంపోజ్ చేసినాం వేడి చేయడం ద్వారా విడగొట్టాం. ఇక్కడ ఏం చేస్తున్నాము, ఆక్సిజన్ని మెర్క్యూరీని కలిపి మెర్క్యూరీ ఆక్సైడ్ తయారు చేస్తున్నాం. ఈ రెండు సిచ్యువేషన్లో కూడా లా ఆఫ్ కాన్స్టాంట్ ప్రపోర్షన్ అనేది వర్తిస్తుందా లేదని చూస్తే 92.6 grams of mercury, 7.4 grams of this one ratios check చేద్దాం. అలాగే నెక్స్ట్ క్వశ్చన్ కూడా మనం ఆన్సర్ చూద్దాం. ఇక్కడ చూసినట్లయితే ద రేషియోస్ ఆఫ్ హైడ్రోజన్ అండ్ ఆక్సిజన్ అప్రాక్సిమేట్లీ 12.5:1 ఉంది. అలాగే కాంబినేషన్ లో కూడా 12.5:1 ఉంది. సో దట్స్ వై ఇట్ ఈస్ ఫాలో ద లా ఆఫ్ కాన్స్టాంట్ ప్రపోర్షన్. యాజ్ వెల్ యాజ్ సెకండ్ కూడా తీసుకుంటే కార్బన్ డైఆక్సైడ్ లో కూడా ఆల్వేస్ ద రేషియో ఈస్ యాజ్ 1:2. తర్వాత ఈ ఆఫ్టర్ దట్ దీస్ ఆల్ థియరీస్ after this all theories, John Dalton gives an atomic theory. That John Dalton gives is important points as postulates of Dalton's atomic theory. One is matter consists of indivisible particles called atoms. ఒక పదార్థాన్ని మనం విభజించలేనంత చిన్న భాగం చేసినప్పుడు దాన్ని ఆటం అని పిలవాలి. మ్యాటర్ కన్సిస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఇండివిజిబుల్ particles called as atoms. If 5 points, very very important. Second one, Atoms are neither created nor destroyed in a chemical reaction. That is the first law of conservation of mass only this is. So atoms are neither created nor destroyed in a chemical reaction. Reorganization of atoms occurs in a chemical reaction. All the atoms of a same element have identical mass and identical chemical properties. Atoms of different elements have different masses and different chemical properties. Compounds are formed when atoms of different elements combine in a simple whole number ratios. This is the law of constant proportions only. So change the union of separation of atoms as in whole numbers. When the atoms of different elements combined in different whole number of ratios, they are from different compounds. Okavela ratios change avute erpadeatvanti products different aithe. If carbon is 1, oxygen is 2, 1:2 ratio lo unte, that is carbon dioxide. If carbon is 1 and oxygen is 1:1 ratio lo unte, that is the another product, that is carbon monoxide. In this way explain that important points that is John Dalton's atomic theory. Which postulates of Dalton's theory is the result of law of conservation of mass? Law of conservation of mass explained that matter neither destroyed nor created. Same like that John Dalton's second postulate also explained that atoms neither created nor destroyed. So first question answer is that second postulate. Another question, which postulates of Dalton's theory can explain the law of constant proportion? We see that fourth one. Compounds are formed when atoms of different elements combine in simple whole number ratios. That is, chemical change is the union of separation of atoms as in whole number. This is explained the fourth one. In this way, we will be okay, thank you to one and all.